Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we'll talk about Newton's second law as it applies to your MCAT. You can find my entire video series along with my forces cheat sheet and practice quiz by visiting my website leiaforsci.com/forces. When you think of Newton's second law, the equation that should immediately pop into your head is the sum of the forces is equal to mass times acceleration, where this symbol here means the sum or simply the addition of. What this tells you is that an object experiencing a net force will experience an acceleration in that direction. So what does this mean? In the last video, we talked about a block sitting on a table experiencing no acceleration to the right or the left, meaning that it's at rest, but we also mentioned that it's experiencing a force of gravity downward, and the force of gravity is mass times the acceleration of gravity, or simply mg. What prevents the block from just going straight through the table is another force in the upward direction completely canceling out the gravitational force, and that's the normal force. And don't worry, we'll devote an entire video to just the normal force calculations. The idea here is that if I set up an equation for the upward and downward force in the y direction, you'll notice that they completely cancel out, and therefore the sum of the force in the up and down direction equals zero, the block does not experience an acceleration. But if I push the block to the right with a force greater than the opposing force of friction, then the sum of the forces in the x direction is to the right, and the block will experience an acceleration. Once I let go of the block, the force of friction is greater than the motion, and so the block will start to slow down and experience an acceleration to the left because friction is opposing the direction of motion. Again, we'll have an entire video just on friction. For now, I just want to focus on the setup to make sure that you understand what's going on. If you have an object experiencing a force, to calculate the acceleration, based on all the different forces, you want to take into account two different versions of this equation. So this is our object in question. We want to look at the sum of the forces in the x direction, which is equal to mass times acceleration in the x direction. And to set this up, you want the positive x to be towards the right and negative x to the left. But you must also take into account the sum of the forces in the y direction, which is equal to ma in the y direction. And to set this up, you have your upward force as positive y and your downward force as negative y. A common scary example where this applies is, say I have the same block, but instead of a table, it's sitting on an inclined plane at some angle theta. I can still show my force going down and normal force going up, but here's where things change. The force of gravity is still going straight down, that's mg, and the normal force is perpendicular to the surface that the object rests on, that's my force n. Now don't worry, I'll do an entire separate video on how to do this type of normal force calculation. What you want to recognize here is that the normal force does not completely cancel out the force of gravity because that's in the y direction, but the normal force sits somewhere between the x and y direction. So if I take the normal force and break it down into the x and y components, you'll notice that the y component balancing gravity is less than gravity because the rest of the normal force is in the x direction. And that means gravity will still have an effect on this object and make it move downward. This is where we have the sum of the forces favors the x direction and favors the motion of the block sliding down. Once you've found the sum of the forces in the x direction and sum of the forces in the y direction, you can find the total force, which may be in the x or y direction, or at some vector in between the two axes. To find the total force, you want to set up the equation, the sum of the forces is equal to the square root of the sum of the forces in the x direction squared, plus the sum of the forces in the y direction squared, and this comes from the Pythagorean theorem, which tells you that f squared is equal to fx squared plus fy squared. If you're not comfortable with this, go back to my MCAT math video series on my website, leiaforsci.com/MCATmath. Now, if this sounds overwhelming, don't worry. Yes, you need to know every step and you need to be able to calculate it all the way through, but the MCAT questions are likely to give you a setup where you'll intuitively know that one or the other equals zero, letting you simplify your calculation so that it doesn't take too long. Now, be sure to join me in the next video where we talk about Newton's third law. You can find my entire series along with the Forces cheat sheet and practice questions by visiting my website, layforsci.com/forces.
Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website, layforsci.com/MCAT tutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at MCATExamStrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, MCATExamStrategy.com.